y en genera belleza tocando y genera armonía musical, empieza a conocer por dentro lo que es la armonía esencial, la armonía humana, y que solo puede comunicar la música al ser humano. Esa revelación es lo que transforma, sublima y desarrolla por dentro el espíritu del hombre. ¿Qué es una orquesta? Una orquesta es una comunidad que tiene por característica esencial y exclusiva, ella sola tiene esa característica, de que es la única comunidad que se constituye con el objetivo esencial de concertarse entre sí. Por tanto, el que hace práctica orquestal empieza a vivir la práctica de la concertación. ¿Y qué significa, en otras palabras, la práctica de la concertación? La práctica del equipo, la práctica del grupo que se reconoce a sí mismo como interdependiente, donde cada uno es responsable por los demás y los demás son responsables por uno. ¿Concertarse para qué? Para generar belleza. ¿Qué es lo que entonces la orquesta ha sembrado definitivamente en el alma de sus miembros? ¿Verdad? Sentido de armonía, sentido de orden implícito en el ritmo, sentido de lo estético, de lo bello, de lo universal y del lenguaje, el lenguaje de lo invisible. Ese lenguaje de lo invisible que se transmite invisiblemente a través de la música.
Deborah Borda. I'm president and CEO of the Los Angeles Philharmonic. The YOLA program in Los Angeles, or Youth Orchestra LA, is our American adaptation of El Sistema. YOLA is inspired by El Sistema, the extraordinary music education program in Venezuela that engages hundreds of thousands of young people every year from all walks of life.
We really hope that at this very young age, we're developing a very clear idea of discipline and hard work and how those things pay off and have very real rewards in the short term and in the longer term.
We take very young children, we get them instruments, we give them lessons.
I've been practicing with YOLA for about 2 or 3 years now. We get to do a lot of music with different artists like Beethoven.
I'm so grateful that this program has come to the city of Los Angeles. I'm even more grateful that it's in this community where these opportunities are not afforded to a lot of children.
Maestro Jose Antonio Abreu, who's of course the founder of El Sistema, puts it in a very dramatic way, and that is, if you put a violin in the hands of a child, they cannot pick up a gun.
A program like Youth Orchestra LA just opens the doors to kids who might not ever take a step outside of their neighborhood, who might not ever have the chance to see what a violin looks like, what a clarinet looks like, and to make the sound of that instrument. It gives these children voices that they might not otherwise have.
We've started small. We have the Expo Center, who are great partners.
We partnered with one of the greatest nonprofits in LA called the Harmony Project.
And we started YOLA Expo. We started with 80 kids in South LA. We now have over 200 in the program, and our first orchestra is performing at the Hollywood Bowl just 2 years later.
This is a big deal. Like, we're gonna be in front of 1,800 people at the Hollywood Bowl. I feel nervous. I've never played in front of so many people.
One of the goals of Youth Orchestra LA is to start several youth orchestras in Los Angeles with community partners.
YOLA is Gustavo's signature program to transform young lives.
The study of music for young people, I've always felt, is a great thing for their general education in so many ways. And Gustavo is naturally a teacher.
His life has been shaped by this program. And a remarkable thing about him is, especially with young people, when he's with them, he is so giving, he gives a little piece of himself. And the message that he has about the importance of youth, the importance of young people making music, and the importance of mentorship. It is really Youth Orchestra LA, the power of youth, the power of music, the power of providing something, a new way for kids who didn't have all of the opportunities. This is the right way to continue to work at making our country great.
Memphis. The rich Delta soil here has birthed incredible music and legendary musicians. Our musical roots run deep. The branches of our musical family tree spread far and wide. Since the 1950s, the Memphis Symphony Orchestra has been connecting Mid-Southerners to that rich music that belongs to each of us.
I enjoy the time that I spend with Mr. Frank because I get to learn new things about my music that I didn't know from the first.
Would you make the right hand do some of the work, you make the left hand do some of the art too. Let's do that. Let's do our division of labor here. One, two, ready, go. Hopefully I've been able to plant some of the seeds of certain skills that I think will be helpful to them. Not just because they're good for music, but because they're good for other things, too.
I've learned how to read music. I've learned how the rhythm goes. It's pretty awesome to spend time with a person, you know, that plays with an orchestra.
The very first time that the students played, after about 2 weeks of working with the mentors, they were all shocked at the way that they were playing because they didn't realize that they could play that well.
Very good. Your sound is a lot better when you...
I'm getting better at my instrument and playing the song and reading music more than when I started at this school.
This B, C, and D can be separate from one another. So you go slur. Good, one more time.
She helps us to read slurs and how to focus on the tempo and the beat of a note.
This program is one of the most important things that I think the symphony can do for the city of Memphis.
It's just amazing to see how, you know, coming from the orchestra class, students are going to math class and they feel much better about going to math class because, you know, they feel like, well, if I just learned this hard scale that I couldn't play for weeks, now I can play this scale, of course I can learn some fractions.
It's teaching me to keep going if I mess up, and like if you mess up on a piece of music, you just try again.
It's leading me to my future, to what I want to be.
Moving to the future, or moving to the future.
And we came here and we said, we're interested in doing this creative workshop, this compositional workshop.
Moving to the future.
Yeah, you got to emphasize.
It's a joint artistic project to try to explore what would happen if we, as the orchestra, came together with a group of senior citizens and tried to make some music together. But we still need to work on music for the first two verses.
Tom said we were going to compose a song. I said, oh, really? You know, so, okay, I didn't know how they were going to do that.
It didn't seem difficult. It seemed quite impossible.
Shut down for no reason, nowhere to hide.
The group decided they were going to do the song about Camden. And I've been in Camden since I was like 10 months old.
When I was a child, we would walk down Broadway and Kane Avenue, and it was like shops and stores, and people from outside of Camden would come to Camden to do their major shopping.
And now it's like a ghost town. And when it breaks my heart when I walk down and see abandoned homes and litter.
Rich in the past, changed so fast.
That brought us all our hopes and our dreams to see Camden in the future like we would like it to be. Almost similar to the past.
So the emphasis is on crying, mother, child.
We are getting into it step by step. Tom is guiding us through the process.
We had to say, no, we don't like that. You know, we want to hear this.
Beautiful. All right, so let's hear it musically.
Even though we're not music majors, we could tell them what we wanted to hear. And they listened to us.
It was a complicated process because everyone had a lot of strong opinions about what this song should say and contain.
Ready? And.
The title, Full of Hope, was my title. So I'm very proud of my baby. I enjoyed the whole song. We all had input.
As a matter of fact, the chorus, Full of Hope, Full of hope. I wrote that melody and gave it to Tom, and so he, of course, you know, he fills it all and makes sense of it. But that was my melody.
But it feels like something else musically needs to happen there.
I didn't think it would be as difficult as it turned out to be, but I'm enjoying it. You know, I've never missed a session since you've been here.
And it keeps you interested, and you can't wait till Wednesday to come again, because you know you're going to learn something that you didn't know before.
We will go on to a future bright for all, full of hope, love, full of hope.
Thank you for the strength to work off my bondage.
So you have a member from the community with his or her story, and then you've got an orchestra member who has come in and helped shape a musical performance around that story.
The
relationship is not just we're coming and we're going to hear what you have to say. It's a two-way learning experience.
Start reading, you could, like.
Second line. Rich had determined that I would give the intro, and immediately after that, he would start playing the music.
When you pause, you wait for me to stop playing, and then you start reading again.
Worked out very well. We coordinated, so we were working together like choreography, you know.
Okay.
We might be completely in over our heads.
It was in a medium that I wasn't maybe comfortable with, and I like putting myself out there and that kind of thing.
You know, the little sounds.
I'm doing something really different. I mean, I'm writing some music, I'm performing off the cuff.
You want to try and like write a theme?
And not that we came up with anything great, but it's just much of a freer environment.
The blackbirds chirrup in the tree over our heads as they fed on the fruits.
Great, I think that'll work. It's a take.
We used to think that you have to have a certain level of education to enjoy classical music, and that is really not so. They're making us aware of music, and now we put together the words.
It's about experiencing the power of music. I mean, what could be more powerful than that?
This phase culminates in a performance in the Gordon Theater at Rutgers.
My kids, I'm like, you gotta take off so that you can come to the concert so you can hear our song. I love it. I love it. I'm excited.
It's important for orchestras to be doing this kind of work because we are looking all the time at our audiences and how our music is relevant to people or not relevant to people, how you make those connections for all different kinds of audiences.